One in a marine paradise. Where fur seals thrive. The other on an isolated island. Surrounded by violent waves. And deadly sharks. This is their story, following the first few months of their lives. As they learn about their different worlds. The little girl is alone. For the first time in her life. Her mother has taken advantage of a brief spell of good weather and gone to sea to feed. This season's pups are also enjoying the fine weather as they learn to swim in the relative safety of the local nursery pool. The pups hang out in loosely knit pods that form whenever their mothers go to sea to hunt. Everything they do is a rehearsal for adult life, even trying to catch a fish. The young girl can hear the other pups splashing in the pool. They are mostly several weeks older than she is, but she is keen to join them. Even if she's not quite sure how to get there. A local crested penguin helps lead the way. At around 9 days old, she is right on track to learn to swim and cautiously checks out the pool. Seals have very good eyesight. And after a quick look around, the brave young pup takes to the water. She seems confident in the water and takes to swimming quickly. But if her mother doesn't make it back, her courage will account for nothing. And where her mother has gone, that is a possibility. She is 5 miles off the Open Bay Islands, searching for squid and small midwater fish that make up the bulk of her diet. She is perfectly equipped to hunt in these waters. Her front flippers propel her forward, while her rear flippers and flexible spine enable her to twist and turn. As she dives, her nostrils automatically close. Her heart rate slows by over 90%. In this state, she can dive down to 750 feet and stay there for over 10 minutes, deeper and longer than any other fur seal species on the planet. But she'll need all her swimming skills if she's to make it back to her pup. Great white sharks have learned to wait in the waters between the feeding grounds and the breeding grounds. In some parts of the world, fur seals will gather in groups to get past sharks and then make a sprint for land. New Zealand fur seal colonies are probably too small to utilize this type of behavior. But they may use other tactics, like porpoising, which is more energy efficient than swimming. It may also help the seals get their bearings as they near the shore. But as seen in other places, even this doesn't always work. The girl pup's mother is hunting for fish and squid off the Open Bay Islands. While she waits on shore, alone. Initially, she was curious about the world she found herself in and joined in with the older pups playing in the nursery pool. But her mother has been away for almost 3 days now. She is suffering from lack of milk and starting to lose body weight. 250 miles to the northeast, on the Kaikoura coast, the little male is a few weeks older now and reaping the high fat rewards of his mother's numerous fishing trips. The exceptional fishing in Kaikoura waters means the mothers are well nourished, so the pups here are nursed longer and grow bigger than fur seals in other parts of New Zealand, including the Open Bay Islands. Just offshore, a visitor has dropped in. A petrel. Maybe after some dolphin dinner scraps. This female dusky dolphin seems intrigued by this newcomer, until she finds some of her pod playing a game of Pass the Seaweed, a favorite game among these intelligent sea mammals. One piece of seaweed lends itself to all kinds of deft maneuvers. The acrobatic dolphins come dangerously close to the petrel. He's taking no chances. Pass the Seaweed doesn't just pass the time. Play in dusky dolphin society strengthens bonds within the pod and increases young dolphins' understanding of the world they live in. The world the red-billed gulls live in allows no time whatsoever for play. One of the two mothers has been busy fishing at sea and is heading home with a crop full of krill. She's about to meet the first chick born in her blended family. And not a moment too soon. The nesting gull needs a break, and the chick is desperate for its first meal of regurgitated fish. The young boy is growing in confidence as well as girth. So when his hungry mother goes to sea to fish, he wanders away, exploring a new part of the beach. Down the shore, he discovers something he's never seen before. A freshwater stream. And a bunch of pups returning to the colony. He doesn't follow them. Instead, his curiosity fueled, he heads upstream to where they came from. He leaves behind the familiarity of the shoreline, where he was born, possibly following a scent up the stream. The further inland he goes, the more challenging the terrain. But the intrepid explorer seems undeterred. Then he makes an extraordinary discovery. The young male pup has found the Kaikoura nursery pool. Every breeding season, when the females go to sea, More and more pups head upstream to this freshwater playground. Sometimes there are 200 pups here. It's the perfect setting to learn social skills, coordination, and the fluid acrobatics of the ocean hunt. Even a harmless play fight is a rehearsal for adult life. If it's at all intimidating to this first-time visitor, the cue backing up behind him helps him overcome his fear. In no time at all, he seems to be having the time of his life. As dusk sets in, some of the pups head downstream to the coast. Hunger and instinct tell them their mothers will be back from hunting soon. But many remain. With newfound confidence, the young male decides to stay. His first night away from home. It is morning on the Open Bay Islands, and a change is in the air. The New Zealand fur seal breeding season is winding down. A lot of the males have already left, and there are just a few stragglers remaining. Many of the females are pregnant again, but their embryos have not started to grow yet. After the egg is fertilized, it waits, suspended in the uterus for 3 months before it starts to develop. This delayed pregnancy means fur seals can time the birth of their pups to the following summer. One of the last females to give birth is now ready to mate. It's a critical moment for her, but a dangerous time for her pup, with a 300-pound male in hot pursuit. And she tries to get her pup out of the way. This may be her last chance to mate before the males leave. But at the moment, she seems more worried about this year's pup getting crushed. Eventually, the male looks elsewhere. His drive to mate, greater than his patience. The female may have saved her pup this time, but there's no hope for this breeding zone casualty. It's been a bad year, and dead pups litter the landscape here on the Open Bay breeding grounds. Perhaps their mothers were the victims of fisheries bycatch, and the pups starved. Perhaps climate-related changes are affecting prey availability, and therefore the mother's ability to feed their young. Or maybe these young pups just didn't learn fast enough when the last storm hit. Storms are common on the Open Bay Islands. And the waves that they generate can rip pups from the rocks. The young female pup is now almost 2 months old and knows to stay clear of the waves as a storm approaches the island. Alone again while her mother is at sea, she joins a group of pups heading inland, up into the bush. Penguins are also making the move inland, away from the violent waves. In the bush, the inhabitants hunker down together to wait out the storm. While down on the shore, a stray male pup, who didn't heed the warnings, faces the storm alone. It is the end of the New Zealand fur seal breeding season. The young girl pup has survived the worst her exposed home could throw at her, and is on her way to becoming a strong and confident member of the colony. The male pup is also thriving in his little piece of paradise. His curiosity and adventurous spirit serving him well. In both colonies, the last bull seals are returning to the ocean for months of feeding. They won't return until the next breeding season. Until then, it's just females rearing their pups in peace. These are the lucky ones, the ones that survived. The young girl pup is becoming used to her mother's frequent hunting trips. Like most of the females, her mother is pregnant. She needs lots of food to feed the embryo that will start developing in a few weeks' time. And she still has another 8 months before she can wean this year's pup. The water in the surge channel has been violent enough to keep the pup from following her mother to sea. But today, she's ready to give it a go. Following her mother on what is her first intentional journey into the wild open ocean. Over the coming months, as her strength and confidence grow, she'll explore the water around the island, perfecting her swimming skills and learning what's good to eat. But it will be a year or more before the young female is ready to dive the deeper ocean. And 4 more years before she will mate and give birth. But for the rest of her life, the Open Bay Islands will be her home. A location full of amazing inhabitants and productive waters, where she will one day raise her own young. For the boy pup on the bountiful Kaikoura coast, the story ends a little differently. The young male has been taking ample advantage of his mother's rich milk and grown fat. He hears his friends playing in a nearby rock pool and goes to check it out. It's an easy slide in. This is heaven for a pup, playing in the safe enclosure of a rock pool. But unlike his female compatriot on the Open Bay Islands, the young male will probably not make Kaikoura his permanent home. Instead, he will become one of the colony's transient males that spends most of his time hunting in other locations around New Zealand, only returning to the colony once a year to fight for the right to breed. The spectacular Kaikoura Coast. on the eastern side of New Zealand's South Island, where the Southern Alps meet the Pacific Ocean. Ohau Point on the Kaikoura coast is home to a thriving fur seal rookery. It's a great place to raise a family. The offshore waters are rich in food. The weather is benign, especially in summer when the female seals bear their young. And there are plenty of rock pools where adolescent seals can learn to socialize. With life this good, it's not surprising the seals have to share their strip of paradise. A permanent population of dusky dolphins live and play in the productive offshore waters. While on shore, 6,000 breeding red-billed gulls keep up an almost constant chatter as they try to defend their territory. The fur seals are one of the newest inhabitants to this coastal paradise. Re-established after 19th century sealers almost brought the species to extinction. Pup injuries are just collateral damage during the breeding season. The males are only here to mate and will head back to sea at the end of the season. The secret to survival is staying out of their way until then. The young male pup has a lot to learn about the world he's been born into. But if he can avoid the males over the next 2 months, he might just make it to adulthood. The male pup's home is 1,300 miles to the east of Australia, on the northeast coast of New Zealand's South Island. ...250 miles away, on the other side of the South Island, are the Open Bay Islands. Here is a very different world. The islands are only 3 miles from the coast, but it may as well be 3,000. So remote and rough are these waters. Even in the middle of summer, the weather can take a sudden turn for the worse. Despite this, the islands are home to one of New Zealand's largest fur seal breeding colonies, with up to 4,000 members. And around 1,000 pups are born here each year. But with abundance comes danger. During the breeding season, great white sharks patrol the waters around the islands, waiting for one of their favorite meals. Mortality is high here, and not just because of the sharks. Starvation, drowning, and even suffocation take their toll. While for some pups, the danger begins before they're even born. Most New Zealand fur seal pups are born after a short labor. This mother has been in labor now for at least 7 hours, with no sign of her pup. The longer she is in labor, the greater the chance her pup might be born too weak to survive. Or worse, be stillborn. Her life is also in jeopardy. Then the weather packs in. Finally, a flipper appears. Not the pup's head. Which means it's a breach. This helps explain some of the delay. But even then, she should have given birth hours ago. A lusty male pays her a visit. But he soon realizes that she's unable to mate. At last, more of the pup is emerging. Then, with a final heroic effort, the pup is born. It's a girl, but she's exhausted and barely moving. Scavengers jockey for position. It's a rocky start for two fur seal pups born on opposite sides of New Zealand's South Island. The boy pup has learned that even paradise has its dark side. While the female endured a tough birth in an equally tough location. But the morning brings a change of fortune for the little girl on the open Bay Islands. Westerly blasts are common here on the edge of the Tasman Sea. But today is almost idyllic. The little girl has recovered from the birth ordeal miraculously well. And while she suckles from her mother, a battle for the placenta begins. Fur seals sometimes eat their own placenta. It's a rich food source for a new mother. But today, a gull and a weka are fighting for possession. The gull may be visiting from the mainland, while the weka is a permanent resident. An endemic species of the New Zealand mainland, weka were possibly introduced to these islands as a food source by settlers or local Maori, sometime in the early 1900s. Unable to fly, they've been marooned here ever since. They are opportunistic feeders. But there is a hierarchy between these two scavengers. And the sneaky weka must work around the more dominant gull. Finally, the weka gets her chance. It's a feast for the whole family. The flightless weka might be an unexpected inhabitant of an isolated offshore island, but they are not the only creatures sharing the little girl's home. There can be hundreds of crested penguins, migratory sooty shearwaters, and little blue penguins, all sharing these two rocky islands, an area of 74 acres. The continental shelf runs close to these shores, bringing cold, nutrient-rich water to the surface. This produces an explosion of life that's drawn fur seals to these islands for thousands of years. Back on the Kaikoura coast, the little boy has made some friends. The last pups have been born. And there's a squabble for the last of the blood-rich placenta. But mothers come first here. This bountiful stretch of coast is a magnet for breeding species that come to raise their young. But not all of them follow the usual parenting strategies. This red-billed female is waiting for her partner to return from a feeding trip at sea. To keep her eggs at just the right temperature, she has to roll them often to ensure the heat inside is evenly distributed. It's hot work, and with no sweat glands, panting is the only way for her to cool down. But no matter how hot it is, she cannot leave the eggs unprotected, or they will be eaten by neighboring gulls. Finally, her partner returns. And it's another female. Female red-billed gulls outlive the males and therefore outnumber them by nearly 10%. To overcome this imbalance, 7% of the red-billed gull nests have two mothers. The females share the parenting duties equally. The fur seals are not so accommodating. This young pup is trying to find her mother. But the other territorial females keep tossing her out of the way. It's an unforgiving world, where mother fur seals are only concerned for the welfare of their own pups. The little boy is now around 10 days old, and the biggest test of his young life is about to begin. He has been feeding around the clock, gaining weight rapidly, which means his mother's fat reserves have diminished just as fast. She must now leave him alone for the first time while she goes to sea to feed. Fortunately, she doesn't have far to go. Less than half a mile out from the Kaikoura Peninsula is the 3,000-foot deep Kaikoura Canyon. Here, deep ocean currents collide with the canyon wall, forcing the cold, nutrient-rich water upwards. It's a biodiverse hotspot where krill and small fish support a dazzling array of marine life. It is this abundance of life that likely attracted seals to the region initially, before sealers wiped them out. And it is probably the reason they have now come back. But seals are not the only hunters here. The rich pickings attract apex predators, like this orca. Back on shore, the little boy watches as his mother leaves him for the first time and heads to sea to feed. Ah! His life depends on how quickly she returns. If she takes longer than 3 or 4 days, he could starve. More than 1 in 3 newborns do. In the meantime, the greatest risk to the young pup's life are the resident adults and the ocean. He can't swim well yet. The next few days will be the longest of this pup's life. Just off Kaikoura lie forests of giant kelp. These graceful submarine plants provide shelter and trap nutrients for a wide variety of fish. It is here that the male pup's mother has caught her first meal after giving birth. A red cod. She'll need to catch more than just one cod if she's to feed her rapidly growing pup. But she doesn't always have to rely solely on her own skills to do this. New Zealand fur seals sometimes cooperate with dusky dolphins to catch prey. Working as a team, dolphins use tail slapping to herd fish into a ball. Once the fish are trapped, the dolphins take turns charging into the bait ball to devour the fish. It is this type of group hunting that fur seals have been known to join in with, and something the young pups may one day participate in, if they make it to adulthood. But back on shore, the little boy is more interested in when his milk supply will return than what he may eat when he's older.